Hello, I'm Seonghyeon, and this is my fellow presenter, Inhwa.
Hi.
We are both media artists and research assistant of KAIST. We would like to first of all thank to JS Conference Korea for having us and everyone who are watching this video. Today, we are very excited to talk about our project, P5 for PT Plus, which addresses the issues of including older adults to coding education. So the major goal of P5 for 50 plus was to contribute in enhancing the physical, emotional, and lingual accessibility of middle-aged and older people to learning coding with P5.js. Before continuing into our presentation, we'd like to briefly introduce Processing Foundation Fellowship Program, which supported the P5 for 50 plus project. If you are also wish to engage in the community by enhancing accessibility to creative coding with processing P5.js or ML.js, you might also wanna consider applying for next year's fellowship. So check out the link if you are interested. We want to start our presentation by answering this question that many people would ask us. Why creative coding education for 50 plus? Basically, it started from our very personal wish to better communicate with our parents and grandparents about what we love to do. And yet, if you look deeper in the Korean society, you can notice some intertwined problems that our parents and grandparents' generations are facing. While digital interfaces and interactions consist of substantial part of daily life in Korea, more than half of the older population feel as though they cannot access what has become the dominant way of communicating with their surroundings. Even more difficulties are found among those who went through their public and formal education before the 1970s, which was only the dawn of the computer education in Korea. To cope with these circumstances, the government has recently offered digital education, for instance, on learning computer software programs and smartphones. However, fewer than 1% of the welfare programs teach coding. Unlike the current trend of welfare policy, we hypothesized that increasing the opportunity for learning coding would be particularly helpful for older adults in raising their confidence toward digital interfaces and interactions. In a way, it is about learning a language for directly communicating with a computational entity, understanding how the computer thinks and how it responds. In that sense, we consider P5.js to be a perfect starter language, especially for those unfamiliar with machines, because the inputs, outputs, processes, and entire logical flows can be intuitively delivered with a variety of interactions. In fact, 500 people from around the world, also from older age group, have expressed their high interest in learning coding for the following reasons. One, to overcome their fear towards the digital environment. Two, to enhance their cognitive abilities. Three, to re-educate themselves for planning for their later life. To better document the older people's actual needs in coding education, we interviewed 13 people with average age 62. These interviewers have commonly appealed their interest in learning new technology and are willing to go outdoors for learning it. And they expressed their preference in learning together with people who share similar challenges. One thing to note about older adults' demographics in Korea is that they demonstrate high confidence in using smartphones as well. Based on this Based on this finding, without holding a P5JS workshop specifically dedicated to older adults, itself can contribute in increasing the learning opportunity for older population. In fact, coding education has actively been adopted in both public and formal and private and informal institutions over the last decades in Korea. And learning resources are getting bountiful both online and offline. However, those materials and curriculums are not very suitable for 50 plus people. I think Inhwa can talk more about this. Right, Inhwa?
Yes, thank you, Seonghyeon. So we started designing this workshop in consideration of the technical access of older adults to coding devices. Like in our formative interview, the older adults demonstrated their confidence and familiarity to smartphones, so we thought we should devise a way through which we can access with smartphones the P5JS learning resources, and also to utilize Web Editor without a separate or refresh window. And what's even better is that we can utilize a smartphone to learn the P5JS anytime and anywhere we want. And in this talk, actually, we've also planned to introduce our P5 for 50 plus workshop, our experiences there. But due to the reversing COVID-19, unfortunately, it's been delayed to late November. And yet the overview of the workshop you can see from the current slide. So if you're also interested in learning more about this workshop itself and the actual voice of older adults on their experiences of learning P5JS with smartphones, please stay tuned till then. But before everything, in preparing for P5JS workshop in Korea, especially for those workshops that are targeting older adults, the Korean translation of materials is a must. So it is important to note that the English, it comes as a double bind for non-English speaking people when learning coding, since code is written in English and most of the learning materials and online forums circulate in English. So as a part of minimizing this lingual barrier, we translated the official website of P5JS in Korean so that not only our workshop participants, but also the entire Korean speaking population can better access the bountiful resources on this website. Just one thing to note, the sketch backgrounds was created by Seonghyeon in celebration of launching a Korean version of the website. Seonghyeon, can you briefly talk about your work too?
Thank you, Inhwa. So the artwork is my reinterpretation of Hunminjeongeum with P5JS. Hunminjeongeum is the native script of the Korean characters and language, invented and promulgated by King Sejong in 1446. I found much similarity between King Sejong's intention of creating Hangul characters with the spirit of P5JS, especially in terms of enhancing everyone's accessibility to lingual experiences.
Yeah, so likewise, in our project outcomes, we try to include not only Korean, but also the average English and digital utilization level of older adults to readjust the learning materials. So in that sense, we also thought that unlike the usual way of learning coding, P5JS can be particularly helpful in enhancing older adults' understanding of coding in multi-sensory manners. We thought it was crucial to offer a wide variety of options for exploring example sketches with readily accessible codes through P5JS Web Editor. So this way they can try out the interaction and tweak with codes and see how the entire process of programming works like from their inputs to outputs. And if you're also looking for P5JS sketches, you might also, you might want to explore this showcase.p5js.org. Is the P5JS 2020 showcase website produced and curated by Connie Liu. It introduces 60 and more P5JS projects that are categorized on their specific themes or interactions such as data visualization, game and sound, typography, etc. So all these aforementioned ideas to our project are capstoned in this prototype you can access on P5450.plus. Like we've constantly emphasized, we discovered a strong need for a learning interface that's specially designed for 50 plus people. Our interviews demonstrated higher confidence in using a smartphone than desktop PCs or laptops. So we wanted to create a mobile-based web application so that they can access P5JS materials and the web editor simply through a single URL on their smartphones, again, anytime and anywhere they want, and without the barrier of the barrier or burden of carrying around a laptop or tablet, or without downloading an application on their phone. In case of P5JS web editor, we embedded that in our application so that the learners can practice coding, customize example codes, save and manage their codes without a separate or refresh window. So this prototype is it's basically like a simplified version of p5js.org, which is the official website of P5JS. We kept the structure and design elements of p5js.org, but used less text and bigger fonts, made more visual elements and interactions come to the front, and placed more focus on the basic concepts of computer programming with hopefully an easier user flow. The official website of p5js is reintroduced as advanced information through hyperlinks. So we propose the P5 450 Plus web application as a stepping stone towards the official website or any other resources that are bountiful, but text-oriented. This is to boost the age group's confidence in self-learning through smartphones. We hope that users feel at ease and have fun with exploring the web application, and then eventually move on to P5JS.org or other resources through hyperlinks for more in-depth knowledge, without being overwhelmed by the depths of it at first sight. So in our P5 450 Plus workshop, we'll be fully utilizing this web application in line with analog or tangible media and contents. In our case, we're using pen markers and color papers so that the participants can actually draw sketches that they want to code later or write down codes. And we're printing out the code sketches in A4 size, and we're framing the sketches so that the participants can have a mini exhibition and take away their materialized results of coding. As for brainstorming on their code sketches, we're asking them to recall their personal memory and stories as a means to reinforce their cognition. Such tasks include visualizing the visualization of their own written, the daily routine, or their self-portrait of their past, present, or future selves, drawings of their beloved living creatures, objects, or a roadmap to their favorite places and their neighborhood landscape, etc. In designing the curriculum, we have not only referred to cognition reinforcement education programs for the older adults, but also the learning methodology and materials demonstrated at other P5JS workshops or classes. So for your reference, we'd like to introduce that you can now access information to P5JS workshops and classes and relevant teaching materials through this page that's newly launching this September. The URL is p5js.org/teach, and the page was designed to document and share P5JS teaching experiences around the world. It's constantly receiving submissions on the teaching cases, so if you got any, you might want to consider sharing yours through this webpage as well. As for our workshop, we have referred to these two workshops in particular, which you can also check out on the Teach page. So on the left, you can see Lauren McCarthy's workshop, who is the very creator of P5JS and also the advisor to our project. So Lauren has led the Smarter Home workshop in South Korea last year, where a fair amount of participants were middle-aged and older, and they engaged in a 2-month-long collaborative P5 projects for an exhibition. Her experience let us ponder more on the re-engagement and sustainability issue of learning coding. So to quote her, teaching coding sometimes is not about losing people. It's about how to keep them engaged instead of scaring them away. Now on the right side, you can see Qianqian Ye and Evelyn Massa's workshop. Qianqian was the mentor to our project, and together with Evelyn, she led a series of workshops called Digital Weaving, Physical Computing. In this workshop, participants transform their codes into tangible materials such as fabric. Their workshop has let us think more about how we can leverage tangible materials and interactions, and then to promote a more intuitive and affectionate way of learning coding. So combining our research and the insight from our mentor and advisor, as well as other P5 educators, we could devise some principles to designing P5 for 50 plus workshops. So we believe a P5JS workshop can start from asking the reason why the participants would want to learn coding, and how the experience can be beneficial for them. This is not only to inform them of social culture functions and effects of computer programming in the contemporary society, but also to keep them motivated throughout the workshop. Now, keeping the learning materials and environment physically and emotionally accessible is never too much to emphasize. In our case, we've considered their physical accessibility to computing devices, the lingual accessibility, and the universal design of learning interfaces. And these three in a row, we can talk about it all together at once. So we think it's important to utilize multi-sensory elements of P5JS in sensorializing the participants' personal narratives, and then materialize the results from digital to analog media so that they can take away their learning experience with a souvenir. We're also considering the souvenir as an at-home device for recalling their memories of learning coding so that they won't forget to re-access P5450.plus when they wish to continue learning. Once again, to emphasize, this is one common methodology actively employed in the fields of gerontology or the studies of the older adults or studies of rehabilitation in terms of improving the improving the 50 plus learners' understanding of, concentration on, and affection towards what they are learning. Providing a time and space for social interactions with other people in the midst of workshop would be helpful. By social interactions, we mean those moments where you can communicate with those people who share similar backgrounds, interests, and challenges, or better yet, with their own family members. Note that in Korea, in case of Korea, the alienation and generational gap issues are biggest challenges to older adults. Last but not least, important to note that for educators themselves to enjoy their moments of teaching. So let us enjoy teaching and learning from our participants. This is all for our presentation. Thank you very much for your attention. And if you have any questions, please do not hesitate to leave comments to this video or send us an email. Thank you very much.